So I'm talking about the evidence. This is what the evidence says about what works. Two main strands. What impacts student performance? One, students' baseline attainment is influenced heavily by the income level of their parents. Heavily. Now, it's not like, well, my parents don't make a lot of money, so I can't learn. That doesn't make any sense. But money influences access to things that do determine whether or not and how much you learn. Like access to prenatal care, you're less likely to get when you don't have the income. Like early parent talk in a rich linguistic environment, we found that that's less rich in households that have moderate or less than moderate income. It's not universal. You can find some low-income households with lots of rich language. But in terms of the odds, exposure to lead paint, you're more likely to be exposed to that when you don't have adequate income to get decent housing. And then that influences your cognitive development. As a matter of fact, in Chicago, if you live in Lincoln Park, nice well-to-do community, you have a 0% chance of being exposed to lead paint. If you live in Austin on the west side, you know what your chances are? 1 in 4. And so that means the schools in Austin have to deal with something entirely different than what the schools in Lincoln Park deal with. Are you all hearing me?
Yes.
And so when we talk about the impact of income, we have to stop saying poverty, because that's easy to dismiss. We have, what levels does poverty pull? It pulls the level of prenatal care, parent talk, exposure to lead paint, access to decent health care, access to decent nutrition, exposure to violence that can impact your cognitive development, right? We have to talk about the specifics, because you can't dismiss those. We have to be careful about how we talk about these influences. So baseline attainment is influenced by income, but you also have academic growth. So no matter how kids come to us, we can help them to grow academically, right? That's on us. However they come, if they come 2 years behind, or if they come in third grade at a first grade level, by the time they're in fourth grade, they better at least be at a second grade level. You better get them to grow at least a year. It'd be nice if we could do more, but at least have them grow. Am I making sense?
Yes.
So that's on us. Now, that growth is still heavily influenced by these things too. But we have to make that effort, and it's been shown it can be done. Now, I've seen this as principal and assistant principal at Johnson and Blaine. When I was at Johnson, the kids would come into kindergarten 1, 2, 3 years behind the kids who were at Blaine. How is that a failing school and the gap is there on day one? How is that a failing school when the gap is there on day one?
Yes.
Those children have been failed long before they've ever reached a classroom. Failed by the alderman, failed by their city councilman, failed by their state rep, failed by their mayor, failed by the business community.
Yes.
And we have to address that failure. We have to hold them accountable. I would say a lot more, but I don't have a lot of time, and I still got to get the charge. I'm like, what are you talking about, Charles?